Hello everyone, my name is Eric and I'll be talking about the effects of social media. So I'm guessing most of us here are on either Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, or Instagram more than a couple of hours each day. Just to give you an idea of how many hours a day we use these social media, in an article written by Helen Popkin, which was posted on CNBC in 2015, she stated that the average American spends about 6.5 hours on their phone, and teens spend about 9.5 hours on their phone on social media. Learning about the effects of social media will give us a better understanding on how we can protect ourselves. First, I will discuss the problems with social media, then some of the causes of social media, and finally the effects and implications of using social media. Okay, so the first problem would be your information being exposed. There are many problems with it by using social media. The problem is most seen in Facebook because based on an article by Becky Gillette in 2015, she stated that people post on their profiles their email address, phone number, birthday, and hometown. This problem is also caused by posting pictures that give out information about you, like posting a picture outside of your school, which would give information that what school you go to. On to the second point, productivity at work is reduced. The University of Maryland did studies and showed that most people cannot go more than a couple of hours without using their phone. It is estimated that the average American spends a fourth of the workday using social media for non-work related activities. This causes businesses to lose about $35 million each year in time that is being wasted. Now that I have discussed the problem, I will now talk about the causes. The first would be catfishing. Based on an article by Kim LaCapria written in March 23, 2013 on socialnewsdaily.org, she stated that there are 83 million fake Facebook accounts, and out of those 83 million, 97% claim to be women. Some ways to avoid this problem would be to search the person's profile by using Google image search and then running the image through Google. Another tip would be to not give away your personal information until you meet the person. An example of catfishing would be Manti Te'o. He plays for the San Diego Chargers. So his problem was that he met a person online and her name was Lene Kekwa. After talking online for a couple of months, their relationship ends when she supposedly dies of cancer. But it turns out that she never existed and it was a fake profile created by Renaya Twice as Soko. Moving on to the second point would be bullying. Cyberbullying is common among young people, especially in middle school and high school. This is started by either sending a mean text, posting a rumor, or posting embarrassing pictures of the person, either videos, websites, or fake profiles. About 7% of students in grades 6 to 12 have experienced cyberbullying, according to stopbullying.org. Now that I have talked about the causes, I will now talk about the implications and the effects. The first effect would be depression. Kids who are cyberbullying have a higher risk of using alcohol, skipping school, they have a lower GPA, and obviously they would have lower self-esteem. Another effect is that the depression can cause the person to be alone in their home and avoid contact with others. Stephanie McCullough is a psychologist at UCLA, and in her article posted in 2014 at everydayshealth.com, she discusses that too much social media is a bad thing because it decreases face-to-face interaction, which leads to depression. Moving on to the second point would be identity theft. Because people post too much information on their profiles about themselves, this can lead to identity theft. more fake profiles are made to steal someone's information. Some ways to prevent this is to make your profile private and also to only try to add your friends and family and try to avoid strangers. Also delete old accounts that you do not use anymore. Now that I told you the effects of social media, let's wrap things up. In conclusion, social media is a great way to be in touch with friends and family, but the most important thing is to be careful. Now that you learned about the problems, causes, and effects of social media, hopefully you can use it more safely.